After this introduction of the problem statement, I will roughly present a solution that's recommended using a three-step process before digging deeper in each of its steps. If you want to know how to well define your microservice architecture, lend your ears to what follows. Before to introduce the proposed solution, I want to precise that I will use all along this course the food to go example to illustrate the presented ideas. I recall that this example was already seen in the previous video when I introduced the microservice architecture. Chris Richardson presented in his book Microservice Patterns a three-step process for defining a good application's microservice architecture. It is not the only way to achieve that objective, but based on a personal experience using it in a couple of projects, I can affirm its relevance and usefulness. This process begins with identifying the system operations. Suppose here that the starting point is some written requirements. A system operation can be defined as an abstraction of a request that the application must handle. It could take two forms, a command, which updates data, or query, which retrieves data. The behavior of each operation is defined in terms of an abstract domain model, which is also derived from the requirements. These system operations become after that the architectural scenarios that illustrate how the services will collaborate. The second step in the process is to determine the decomposition into services. There are several strategies to choose from, but we will talk about that a bit later in this presentation. No matter the use strategy, the end result has to provide services that are organized around business concepts rather than technical concepts. The third step is to define the API of each service. To do that, you assign each system operation identified in the first step to a service. Basically, a service might implement an operation entirely by itself, but if it is not the case, it might need to collaborate with other services. In that case, you have to determine how these services will collaborate. It is important to remember that this proposed solution is not a process you can follow mechanically. It's likely to be an iterative process that involves a lot of creativity.